Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zollotech, and there has been a bunch of different apps that have been updated for iOS, iPad, and Mac. So I thought we'd talk about what's new as far as that goes, as many of you have asked me to bring this video back, as I was doing this regularly for the past few months. Now, the first change has to do with Twitter. Now, Twitter for Mac seems to be problematic for a lot of people, where it was crashing and more. I personally haven't had too many issues other than it refreshing oddly, but it does seem to be an issue. So it looks like they are going to have to fix that with a software update. Twitter Blue, which has additional features such as allowing you to change your icon here. So if I go into Twitter, you can see I can change my icons around and more, and it allows me to switch between whatever I want. And if we go back home, you'll see it's pink now. We can switch to this or different seasonal icons as well. However, it has some additional features such as reader, themes, custom navigation, labs, and more, but they've raised the price from $299 to $499. So I'm not sure it's worth that. I may need to cancel it, but I thought I'd share that with you, as it's something that's been changed recently. Microsoft Teams for Mac today gained Apple Silicon support. So as you can see on the Microsoft website, let's close out of that. And on the Microsoft website, you can see it says announcing Microsoft Teams optimized for Apple Silicon. Now, you could use Teams on here before using Rosetta and it wasn't a problem, but now it's native and works properly on Apple Silicon, should be faster, quicker to connect, and much more. So that's been updated starting today. Also, in case you haven't heard, on iPadOS, it looks like Apple is going to be pushing back iPadOS 16 to not be launching alongside iOS 16. This is according to a recent report by Bloomberg. Apple has done this before with iOS 13 and iPadOS 13. And according to Bloomberg, it's taking a little time to get things right. And I welcome that. Apple can take their time, make sure it works really well. And if we scroll down, you'll see here, it's not the first time it's happened, but they released iPadOS 13 on September 24th after iOS 13, which was on September 19th. So again, not the first time it's happened, but I'd be happy to have them get this right, take their time, get everything working well. Let me know what you think about that in the comments below. TikTok continues to face concerns in the United States over privacy and more, but has recently filed a trademark for what could be a new music service to compete with Apple and Spotify. So depending on its future status of TikTok, we could see maybe TikTok Music or something else like that. Spotify Premium is getting an update soon as well. So if we go into Spotify, currently we have the play button, but it looks like they're going to split this into a play and shuffle button, where it would have you also be able to choose between those different options. Prior to this, there hasn't been that option. And also Spotify has added a new friends mix to blend your likes and a friend's taste in music together. They've said that friends mix is based on the blends you've created with your loved ones, according to Spotify. And if you've already blended with a friend, you're on your way to receiving a friends mix. So expect that to be showing up soon. If you haven't created one already, you can do that. If you've used Amazon Drive, they've announced that they're going to be ending this at the end of 2023. So if you had 5 gigabytes free, Amazon is shutting down the service, and the shutdown will have no impact on Amazon Photos or videos, but Amazon says this is more to fully focus their efforts on photo and video storage. So this is something that will be going away soon, within another year or so. So if you need to store your files somewhere, go for iCloud or maybe Google Drive or Microsoft or others. Continued proposed legislation in the USA and EU may have a major impact to iOS in the future, banning default apps from being installed when you first set up your iPhone. The EU actually did this some time ago with Microsoft, with Windows, and 9to5 Mac actually shows what this could look like if they were to actually push these sorts of things through, where Apple may have to give an option to browsers, music players, maps apps, and more. So you may have that option when you set up a phone in the future. It depends if these legislation options go through, though. Google Maps has been updated, and it now allows you to not only share locations with others, but also get notifications when they arrive or depart a location. You can do this now if you're using Find My, but it's something that hasn't been built into Google Maps until now. Of course, there's privacy settings here. You can turn this on or off, but maybe you're at a theme park together, say Disney, and you want to make sure you're nearby or you want to meet up somewhere. It's an easy way to know that. So that's something that's been brought to Google Maps, along with other features that have been introduced throughout the summer. Instagram recently rolled back its design where it looked more like TikTok and was just a video sharing service such as YouTube Shorts. Now it's rolled back to what we had before, focusing more on photos, at least on the main menu. menu. So that's something that got a lot of criticism. They've rolled back. I'm glad to see that. I really like Instagram for photos, not necessarily reels or video. I think that's best left to maybe TikTok or YouTube. But let me know what you think about that in the comments below. Now, if you use Nintendo Switch and you have the Nintendo app installed, Nintendo Online will now allow you to send friend requests directly from the Nintendo app. This is something you couldn't do before. It makes it a little bit easier and now has that access. So if you use the Switch Online app or you use Switch Online to play with friends, you can now send friend requests, but you will need iOS 14 or newer in order to do that. Now, Apple Maps also gets an update, and this is something I thought it had, but didn't for a while. And if we go into Maps, and as you can see in Hawaii, if we go down to Drive, we now have cycle directions. Prior to this, it was missing and was not available in all 50 states. Cycle directions are now available in Apple Maps all throughout the US and also in parts of Canada, such as Toronto, Montreal, and Vancouver, also parts of China, London, and Barcelona. So hopefully they bring this to more countries and more different locations, but now it's in all 50 states. Cycle directions with different things such as time and the actual incline and more, as you can see here. So it's great to have that. Of course, Google Maps has had that for a while, but now it's on Apple Maps if you prefer that. The Craft app is one of those apps that I really like a lot and is an alternative to Apple Notes. I use it from time to time. It has a really nice layout and now has its biggest update since 2022. And they've updated a completely reworked commenting system, introduced mentions, comment mentions, and notifications. So you can comment here on this. If maybe you're collaborating with someone, comment that you need to change it or something else. So they've completely reworked this, allowed you to change this up a little bit. And it just is continued to be one of my favorites as far as its overall simplicity, the way it looks, and more. Now, one of my favorite Apple products of the year, despite its many criticisms, is the Apple Studio Display. The Mac Studio Display or Apple Studio Display is a really great display to use. It's super simple. One Thunderbolt cable does everything, but some people are having audio issues. And while this is not necessarily related to a new app, Apple has acknowledged it and said they're going to fix it fairly soon via software. It is not a hardware issue with the speakers. Some people are having audio issues where it cuts out and other odd issues. I've personally had it cut out, and the way you fix that is unplug the Thunderbolt cable, wait about 10 seconds, plug it back in, and that fixes it. If that doesn't, you can unplug the Studio Display. It reboots like an iPhone and then works again. This is quite a frustration for such an expensive display, but does appear to have an update coming to fix that soon. So I just wanted to make you aware. Also, the Safari technology preview has been released again, a new version with an update that actually adds about 150 new changes and updates total. You can see it here for macOS Ventura and macOS Monterey. So they released this on July 27th and it's release 150. So it has a bunch of different changes and updates. You can read more about it here and download it if you want to. And you can see its release notes. So if you go into the release notes, you can see different things they've updated, changed, and improved, or fixed. Recently in the App Store, at the bottom of the arcade section, they had a leaving soon section with a bunch of different apps that were leaving soon. Those apps have been removed now, and that section is no longer here. So hopefully we don't see any other games leaving soon, but they have removed that. If you have those games, you can play them usually for up to 2 weeks. And then if you buy the game from the app developer, usually the saves can carry over if they allow it through iCloud. If they don't, unfortunately, you would have to start again. Hopefully they do though, and hopefully we don't see more leave the arcade. Also, within the App Store, you're going to see more things advertised. App developers can now advertise their app right along in the Today view. And also under specific apps, if you scroll to the bottom, maybe we'll just pick this one, go all the way to the bottom, you'll see more here. And if there's more or you might also like, you could see an advertisement in this section. So that's something you may see very soon as Apple has started to allow developers to do that. Also, newly coming to the arcade very soon is an updated version of Jetpack Joyride. You can see it here. It says launching this August, play Jetpack Joyride 2. So if you're a big fan of that game, I know my family is a big fan of Jetpack Joyride and has been using this game for a long time. I just reinstalled it on this device, but this is something that I played from the very beginning when it first came out. So if you're someone that loves it, there should be a new version very, very soon. Now, every day I have people message me about YouTube with picture in picture. Some people are starting to see it active in the United States as it's available free. And some people are complaining, as they should around the world, that they don't have it for free and have to pay for premium. If I go into one of my videos, you'll see it's working for me, not for everyone, but unfortunately it's just not available free around the world. Hopefully it is very soon, as it's something I find very useful, specifically on the iPad though. I use it all the time. Let me know if it's active for you though in the comments below. If we go over a few pages here, I wanted to share with you the Focused Work app. It's been completely redone. And if we go into the app, I just wanted to share with you what it looks like when you first open it. You can use this to actually set up focused work times based on the Pomodoro technique. So you can set maybe work for 25 minutes, as you can see here, a break for 5 minutes, and you can set it up to be more productive. Some people really prefer this way for productivity. And if we go to next here, you'll see we can create a focus session and then select from many different things. And it is a paid app at $4.99 monthly, or you can pay for an annual or lifetime pass. So we'll just hit X for now, and you can add a planning stage, add a work stage, add a break stage, and a focus session. So if you really like to use this technique, this app has been updated to look very clean and very modern, and definitely check it out if you're interested. I'll leave a link in the description. Now, WhatsApp, if you're someone that uses that app for your main chat app, is gaining a new feature fairly soon for group admins. This will allow group admins to delete any message for any participant. Now, it's currently in beta, but is something that should be coming very soon to the WhatsApp app. So if it's something you use regularly and you're in big groups and you need to delete chats maybe from some people, according to WA beta info, that should be coming very soon. Currently though, it's only available on the Android users beta, but again, they usually bring things across platform. And so that's it for all of the app updates this past week. If you found anything else that's a huge update, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below, whether that be a different app I didn't mention or something else. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.